Hello, my name is David Rue, and I am the Global Chief Medical Officer for Microsoft. I'm a physician, a technologist, and a health services researcher. Over the past 25 years, I've studied how technology can be used to improve health outcomes, specifically access to care, quality of care, patient safety, and ways to improve the patient and provider experience. I'm excited today to be able to share with you how mixed reality can be used to transform healthcare and improve outcomes. To do that, I'd like to share with you some slides and some videos. So let's just jump right to that. The real exciting things about mixed reality is that the imagery and the visualizations give you the sense that you are actually there and that these animations are real. It allows us to be able to immerse ourselves into environments and be able to think of ways that we might be able to interact with each other and the environment in ways that we've never thought of. Now, oftentimes this is viewed in the context of entertainment or fun and exciting things. But what we've also seen is that there are several use cases that could be relevant for both clinical practice, education, and training. But before we jump too far into this, I wanted to provide a disclaimer regarding the things that I'll be talking about as part of this presentation. I'll be covering both slides and sharing videos, but largely this is about the art of the possible. These are things that could potentially be done with the platform. Now, in some cases, we have partners, ISV partners that have built on the Microsoft platform and the leveraging the Microsoft tools to be able to create immersive experiences that have been validated and approved through regulatory mechanisms and are now marketed for certain use cases. I'll showcase some of those. But what we also want to recognize is that there's a desire for Microsoft to be able to provide the platform, but not necessarily replace the clinical decision-making that clinicians have. We also are looking to make sure that we are not making any claims regarding the accuracy, safety, and the reliability of the technology and the platforms as it pertains specifically to the mixed reality clinical use cases. Now, with that said, let's just jump right into it. And let's talk about how mixed reality can empower every individual and organizations across the planet to be able to achieve more. In order to do that, let's start thinking about the paradigm of healthcare. In fact, there are many things that we look at healthcare as being tried and true. These are sayings that oftentimes have been instilled into our daily practice, one of which is see one, do one, teach one. This was coined by Dr. William Halstead in the 1890s, and it specifically referred to the fact that clinicians in the course of training need to see several types of procedures. They need to see several types of patients with certain conditions, and then they need to perform the procedures on the patients and gain some expertise. And then eventually they get to the top of the pyramid where they're able to communicate and teach others how to do this. As you can imagine, this is a very narrow pyramid. It doesn't allow us to be able to scale this. And unfortunately, that has created problems when we think of access to care. With virtual reality, with mixed reality, augmented reality, we have tools now available to us to be able to create immersive experiences that can transform the opportunity for providing education and training. What we want to also recognize is that the devices that we now have available that allow us to be able to change the way that we see the environment, to be able to see three-dimensional images and be able to understand how these images can interrelate with each other. It allows us to be able to not only see it, but potentially change the way that we look at the world. This is a quote from Satya Nadella, the CEO of Microsoft. When you change the way you see the world, you change the world you see. And that's exactly what we're talking about here with mixed reality. In the context of clinical use cases, we are going to focus on three. The first is around holographic patient consultation. And what that really means is in the course of talking to the patient about a procedure or a particular type of intervention, we oftentimes need to communicate information in ways that go beyond words. A picture would be great, but a three-dimensional interactive picture that one can look at that may be specific for them is exactly what patients need. Now, in the context of consultation, we'd love to be able to bring consultants in on every visit. It's impractical to be able to do that. But with virtual care and with some of the tools we have now available, we can do remote expert consultation and have them available all at the time that we're seeing the patient. and have those consultants be able to see the same type of things that the individual clinician is that's standing right in front of the patient. And in terms of training, simulations that allow us to be able to understand the different anatomies, to be able to provide procedures and enable junior clinicians to be able to practice in a safe setting, but also teach them the proper way to do things and avoid certain aspects that could lead to danger. That's something that we now have available with these mixed reality applications. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to start off first talking a bit more about the technology that underlies a lot of this. Now, when we think of mixed reality, probably the very first thing we think of is the headset, the HoloLens or the HoloLens 2. And that is a core part of what we're talking about. But the imagery, the analysis is actually being done at the back end with a powerful platform on Azure. It's called Microsoft Mesh. And that allows us to be able to create the three-dimensional images, that allows us to be able to pull the data from the different sources and be able to provide that level of interactivity and immersive nature. Additionally, Microsoft Mesh interfaces not just with the HoloLens, but a variety of other types of technology tools, such as PCs and mobile devices, as well as other virtual reality headsets. So we can create an ecosystem of different types of devices that can be used by clinicians and patients as they're immersing themselves or working with individuals that are in the immersed environments. And then on top of that sits the applications. The Dynamics 365 has allowed us to be able to create immersive experiences that connect us to different individuals. We now have Microsoft Mesh apps, Altspace VR apps, and of course, partners are building on these platforms and creating incredibly immersive and important types of clinical applications using the Microsoft technologies. And that's what I'd like to share with you, some of those partner solutions in the healthcare space that are really transforming the healthcare industry. So let's start focusing on these partner solutions. The first is around holographic patient consultation. As I mentioned before, what we're doing is we're going beyond simply showing a picture, but creating an interactive tool for both patients and providers to be able to communicate. And in this example, what we're going to be talking about is the Microsoft HoloLens 2 combined with Applicar's Virtual Surgery Intelligence, or VCI. So let's take a look at this video to understand a bit more about this.
Medicine is in the midst of digital change. Mixed reality and artificial intelligence are already improving patient care today. Virtual Surgery Intelligence, or VSI, is doing just that. With this software solution, MRI, CT, and other medical scans are displayed in 3D in Microsoft HoloLens 2 mixed reality glasses. This gives the patient a deeper understanding of the results, surgical procedures, and treatment methods. Before surgery, the doctor uploads the CT and MRI data onto HoloLens 2. The VSI recognizes the patient through anatomical landmarks and positions the stored image on the surgical site with millimeter precision. During the after-surgery round, the patient's data is quickly retrieved and displayed using VSI and HoloLens 2. At a glance and without a computer, the doctor can concentrate fully on the patient, answer questions, and discuss follow-up medical care. Being able to easily dictate a report, take photos, and retrieve archived images saves valuable time, facilitates everyday life in the hospital, and provides quality assurance. That will also make other processes in the hospital more efficient. VSI and Microsoft HoloLens 2 define a new medical standard.
So what we saw there were two important use cases. The first was around pre-surgical planning, using the HoloLens to help understand exactly what the procedure would involve and educate the patient as well. And then the other was after the surgery or after the procedure, now taking a look at all the different ways that these technologies can be used to improve operational efficiency, but also imagine being able to pull down the images from the CT MRI, recreate the new structure and compare that to the old. These are the opportunities for how we can apply this in the clinical setting. And one other thing that we've seen is that with this type of technology, we can also provide consultation where experts and other clinicians can all gather around the patient virtually and provide their input. Now, this was something that we had seen take fold during the pandemic, which the Microsoft HoloLens 2 in combination with the Microsoft Dynamics 365 Remote Assist enabled clinicians from the National Health Services to be able to take care of COVID patients. What I'd like to do is I'd like to be able to show you a video that was provided to us by the NHS Imperial College Health to be able to understand exactly how this was deployed.
The concern was that we were going to have mass casualties with thousands of people dying and that the hospital was going to be overrun. And it was immediately obvious that we were not protected, we didn't have enough PPE. And so there was a lot of fear that actually we were all going to get really sick. And then in the second week of March, that's exactly what happened. You know, we lost a third of our team in a week. I was sat there at the beginning of the COVID pandemic and I counted 29 people in a close proximity in a single trauma call. And I was thinking, well, if this is how we're going to run the next few weeks, a lot of people are going to get sick and we have to change this really dramatically. The simple concept was, look, we're going to create completely virtual ward rounds. Rather than sending four people, we're going to send one doctor in. We very quickly started working with the headsets to identify some use cases. So when you place the headset on your head, what the user will see is a virtual screen or a mixed reality screen, which they can position into any real space in the room that they're standing in. And on that screen at the moment will be the face of one of their colleagues who will be interacting with that user through a webcam based on a desktop. We can call other experts that we might want to call into that clinical scenario. And we can also pull up images and content. So we can look at electronic healthcare record data or x-rays or images. And what it means is that you have all the information, all the specialist care that you need at the patient's bedside, there and then. And it's all in one headset. When this crisis hit, it became apparent that the NHS had to work in a different way, and through really high-level strategic kind of digital infrastructure projects, Teams was just nationally adopted by the NHS. Teams really is now, I would say, an essential tool. We could not run our organization pretty much without it. The fact that their staff are safe, their ward rounds are really efficient, and that they can communicate more effectively with their staff. COVID-19 will change everything forever in terms of the way we work and how we work. In terms of mixed reality, HoloLens 2 really is the only viable product that we have in the space. And I can see a point where these sorts of tools will be the norm, where you will go on a ward round, or you will go into a clinic, or you will go into an environment that might be high risk, that might be challenging, or where you might need specific capabilities of these sorts of technologies, and it will be there, and you'll just use it, and it won't be a novelty. What I'm absolutely convinced of is that we are just at the very beginning of a very long and exciting journey. And I think what's been very important about COVID is actually it's just given us a real shot in the arm and a huge step change in our perception of these technologies and what value they might bring.
Looking at now opportunities to apply mixed reality in a real world setting to be able to provide those level of virtual collaboration. There's actually been studies that have been performed on this to show the significant reduction in PPE as well. So in addition to protecting the clinicians from exposure to the virus, what we've also seen is a significant decrease in PPE or personal protective equipment. One other area is augmented teaching. And this is an opportunity for us to be able to apply mixed reality to individuals that are in the course of training. It could be medical students, nursing students, pharmacy students, anyone that needs procedural training, as well as residents and other types of individuals that are junior faculty. It provides an incredible opportunity for us to be able to help us understand everything from the anatomy to surgical procedures. And again, this scenario is a combination of the Microsoft HoloLens 2 technologies with, in this case, Interactive Commons Holo Anatomy application. And this was done and tested at the Case Western Reserve University. What we saw with the Case Western Reserve University analyses was that the students that were using the Holo Anatomy solution with the HoloLens 2 had a 50% higher retention rate and 40% less clinical class time. So an extraordinary opportunity for us to be able to enhance and improve the efficiency of teaching for clinicians. Now, let's get back to what we just talked about before, the technology that underlines this. Much of what we're talking about here is in the context of Microsoft Mesh. It is on Azure, so there's a significant amount of AI that's been applicable, but we've also built on top of that. And on top of that, we've created an opportunity for individuals to be able to collaborate. Imagine being able to go into a virtual conference room, have an image of the particular organ in three dimensions in front of you, and rather than all of the participants being there just through a video conference, their avatars are there, and the avatars can interact with the actual organ, be able to then dissect it, show particular areas, have people look at different angles. This is what is possible now with Microsoft Mesh. And more recently, Microsoft has announced that Mesh can be launched directly out of Microsoft Teams, which gives us an opportunity to be able to then leverage the fact that individuals and organizations are now leveraging collaboration tools such as Teams for telehealth and virtual care, and then launch into these environments. An incredible opportunity to provide intersection between the different Microsoft products. And that's exactly what Microsoft is doing. We are taking a look at all the different technologies that we have available today, everything from Azure to Teams to Dynamics and all the platforms that we have built on top of it, including Mesh, and integrating them all. But at the center of all of this is healthcare data. And if we think about how healthcare data needs to flow from all the different systems, a great way to think of visualize it is with this circle or this diagram in front of us. Imagine it being divided into three parts. In the upper left-hand part, we're now talking about insights and the ability to understand the individual at a very personal level. That means we need to pull data, not just from our environment, but also from the electronic health record, from other data sets, and normalize that through open APIs and FHIR standards. In the process of bringing all these different data sets together on a common platform, we now have the ability to apply artificial intelligence on top of it. And in that context, we can apply more than just simply the context of what we know to be visualization of the imagery, but we also can potentially apply AI to transform some of the information into decision support, ways that we can now act upon it. And then from there, it needs to be collaborated and coordinated. And that is something where the collaboration tools that we've just talked about can be incredibly helpful. Part of what we're now talking about is a transformation of how virtual care is being combined with artificial intelligence. But what we are also seeing is that there are other virtual care and AI tools that we can have at our disposal. We have seen chatbots and the rise of the information, the need for consumers to be better informed, all being brought into a virtual care environment. We've seen the use of voice technology being converted from voice to text, understood who's actually talking. And then from there, the AI will allow us to be able to structure that into a clinical progress note, which then can be integrated into the medical record. This is also something that has been launched during the pandemic as part of the ambient clinical intelligence technologies that are now embedded into Microsoft Teams for virtual care. We have now an ability to transform the way that virtual care is delivered by bringing AI and ML into the to the technology suite. So now what we're talking about is an opportunity to reimagine what healthcare can be. We're getting better insights by connecting surgeons and clinicians with the medical data that matters most. Better experiences. Now surgeons or students can perfect their skills by practicing on virtual tools that are in three dimensions. And then providing better care by allowing us to be able to provide preoperative planning, postoperative analysis, and better information that's provided to the patients as part of this overall experience. And throughout this all, what we are learning is that mixed reality has an incredible potential to transform the way that we take care of patients and that we train clinicians across the world. Thank you very much.